I'm Maria Menounos, and you're tuned in to AfterBuzz TV, the ESPN of TV talk. Now, let the buzz begin.
Hey, what's up, everybody? We are back with AfterBuzz, Real Housewives of New Jersey. After show, I'm your host, Angel Saunders. I got my girl, Bree, with me, and Russell. Bree, hey. As we all know, from Jersey. Russell was with us last season, and speaking of season, we are almost to the end of this
one. I know.
This is the reunion part two. There's only three.
Yeah.
So it's looking like it's almost to the end. So let's
It is the end.
Yeah. Let's get right to it. I mean, this tonight was a little bit juicier than the rest. What did y'all think?
I agree. I was pretty entertained with the episode tonight.
Yeah.
My favorite was when the men came out.
Okay.
They always keep it real. This is what I like about them.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did like how they brought Bill out. It was like a reenactment from when they went to Jersey and Bill finally got wasted because he always kind of seems a little bit uptight, you know? So it was fun to see the guys let loose. It's always fun, I guess, when they have the guys because we see so much of the women, and to finally see how they are is always interesting. We talked about Teresa's sex life.
Yeah, the dryness is real.
Yeah, Teresa was talking about there's been no one in her life, you know, on that
level. She's definitely lying.
She's for sure lying.
She's so lying.
She says, Teresa says there's been no one in her life on that level ever since she and Jim split. Yeah.
Okay.
But she says that, you know, she's not, you know, closed on an idea. Like, she would love to. She wants it. She wants a Jewish guy, actually.
I mean, look, Joe is very opinionated and boisterous. Mm-hmm. So I think Teresa is playing coy. I'm sure she's done a little some here, a little some there. There's times where her kids aren't always home. They go to school.
Yeah.
And her dad probably takes naps during the day. Okay. So
I don't think she would bring anybody back to the house.
I think she might.
I think she would go out of her way to, like, step outside.
No, but think about how big her property is. And if she steps out, right? So if her property's big, anybody can drive in at any given moment. But if she goes out in public, it's like possible that their paparazzi
it'll get leaked. I mean, her stories have already been leaked. That's why I'm kind of with Bree, and I think you said you're not buying it either.
Oh, no, I'm not buying it.
Yeah, I'm with both of you guys on not buying it. She hasn't done anything because we've seen her with the younger guy who Margaret kept making the young jokes about. We've seen her with the pool guy. And so,
First of all, I'm here for both of them because the pool guy is a contractor.
He's got his own money.
And so they have history.
Yes.
Yeah. Like Margaret was saying, she wants to see him with, she wants to see Teresa with a lawyer or a doctor. But hello, this guy's like building pools for millionaires. So yeah. I think he'll do just fine.
And the 25-year-old is a luxury real estate agent.
Okay. So
he's bringing in those commission checks. Exactly. 6% to be exact.
Exactly. So I think that Teresa could have fun with both of them. I think she has. But, you know, and that's not, well, technically it is a bad thing legally because they
not legally.
It's just that means
the thing, the new thing is to stay married. That way you don't lose your assets or your kids don't get screwed over. And
yeah, but you
just
can't have that fun when you're still married.
What she I'm can. Worried about is Joe trying to screw her up. By
legally,
trying
right?
to say, oh, well, she's cheating on me. She's sleeping with other guys. And then he tried. That's something I would be worried about.
But Joe was seen with those girls in, what was that, Miami or something like that? And they weren't separated yet,
no, not
right?
Miami.
That
is,
in Italy.
Tropical.
It was in Italy?
It was either Italy or Mexico.
It was somewhere very tropical. And I don't know. They weren't separated yet at that point. So if Joe tries to play with Teresa, she could play with him right
Here's
back.
The thing, though. They can stay married, but when they go to file taxes, they can file married and separate, which then at that point they're legally
is
completely separated, meaning that they don't have to hold each other accountable for any survival on each half, so they can all claim that when they go to a court, if they ever go to court. Or this could always be to protect their daughters, because the daughters will have full access to both assets if anything was to happen to either one of them, meaning that if there's a step-parent involved, the step-parent wouldn't be able to override what's supposed to be done.
Come on, law school.
We also need to know the specifics of the prenup that she has signed with him, too. Because all of that could be void if
the
prenup says cheating, no money.
Yeah,
because there are clauses like that.
But
speaking
of cheating and money, Teresa's already said in a past episode that she caught Joe with a girl in his office, right? So, I wonder.
She didn't say that.
Yeah. I think
Are we talking this season?
She mentioned it this season, but yeah. I don't think she... Melissa said it. I think Melissa mentioned it.
Jacqueline also said it several seasons back.
Yeah, so I'm sure Teresa knows. Like, clearly she's the one who found it, and these women know about it, so...
Teresa did say he had several cell phones.
So I don't think the cheating thing is anything new. We even saw that... We even saw... Melissa, what did she say that Joe does talk to Teresa like that when the cameras aren't around and stuff? Because Teresa's like, he only talks to me like that. Like, that's her voice that I cannot stand.
I can't deal with public humiliation. You cannot respect me in private and disrespect me in public.
Thank you.
And you're my husband. Like, there's no way. And I treat you like a king on a daily basis, no matter whether the cameras are on or off. You got me confused.
Yeah, I think that so many people just in general, like, period... If you, like, disrespect me in front of people, now it's a whole nother level because you've got this audience that's giving their opinions and their two cents that no one asked for.
Yep. You know, it's funny you say that because today, while I was doing all my research and everything, I really thought of chivalry and if it's dead.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it's talked about we should bring back chivalry, but we're also at this point in transition where everyone wants to be equal to one another. So when it comes to chivalry, it's almost... gentlemen being the more powerful, dominant, and women being delicate, but women are stepping, like, they're on a different level than they were back in the day, so I don't think chivalry is necessarily the right thing to be, but I think some people are taking this in the wrong direction, meaning that they have to be overly aggressive, overly macho, overly testosteronic, for lack of words in my mind, and that's why he acts the way he does.
I don't know. Maybe he's just a dickhead.
Yeah, maybe he's just tired of Teresa. I don't know. I think he said he never wanted to marry her in the first place.
But I think he's a strong woman.
He's an old school Italian man.
Teresa just turned to a strong woman. Yeah. I think she was strong towards the other women and would shake tables and throw drinks and things like that. But as far as Teresa and Joe, that newfound confidence came.
She's been weak for a minute.
Yeah, that newfound confidence came with the diet and the bikini, whatever it was.
It came once she got out of jail and she had that animosity after losing her mom.
Yeah.
That's when she started really finding her strength. Because when you go back to when she was throwing tables, when she was beefing with Jackie, had issues with Melissa and Joe before they even got on the show and after. So she's been weak for Joe for a really long time.
Yeah, and I don't think that is... like the chivalry part when it comes to Joe.
Yeah.
I think that he just, like he said, he never wanted to be married and now
he's miserable.
Been in this marriage for over 10 years and now he's got a TV show and like now everyone knows when he has girls in his office.
Do you think it's more of a woe is me kind of thing because he got caught up or...
I mean, even if it is a woe is me, there's better ways to handle it.
Yeah.
Like, you don't have to talk to a woman or anyone like that.
Right.
You don't have to do it publicly. Mm-hmm. Like, if you're going to do it, which, like I said, you shouldn't. Mm-hmm. But you definitely shouldn't do it publicly. Like, I know divorces are frowned upon, but this is even more frowned upon. Like, don't stay in a horrible relationship. Like, if you don't want to be married, then do the opposite.
Here's the thing, too. And this is rough because in today's times, things are so different.
Mm-hmm.
You almost have to date for 10 years because technology and everything is advancing so fast. People are changing characteristics the way that they didn't do before. So now we have the devil playing on one shoulder when it comes to social media, right? Mm-hmm. Because we never had to worry about DMs. We just had to worry about private phone calls. But now we're worried about private phone calls, DMs,
screenshots.
And then Facebook comes out with discreet messaging on one device. So these are all things, it's almost like you can't necessarily jump into a marriage less than 5 years into the relationship.
Why would Facebook even do that?
Because Facebook is shady.
Thank you.
But I mean, Joe is shady.
As I turn my phone.
Regardless of all the technology and stuff, Joe is shady as an individual.
Yeah.
And I think that's just him as a person. His character is just very questionable. And I don't think he ever wanted to be a husband. I don't think he cared to be a father.
Right, he said that. And then... rough. He also might not care to be on TV, just like, this is how I usually bring up the Kardashians. How Kanye didn't really want to be a part of their show, but you married Kim, so...
it's part of your life.
There you have it. So we may not love Joe that much, but we sure do love our fans.
We sure do.
Our viewers.
We sure do love our fans, and we have to take a moment to make sure we say thank you for tuning into us every single week and being so faithful and loyal, making us, at AfterBuzz, the ESPN of TV Talk. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Give us a 5-star rating on iTunes. Give us a thumbs up. We're always appreciative of everything you guys have to say. So make sure you follow us also on all our social media platforms.
Yes, please.
All right, you guys. Well, tonight, as we said earlier, we saw that the husbands joined the panel. And I was really, not shocked, because we saw it talked about before, but the fact that Jennifer and Bill really sometimes, what would they say, once a month or once a week? I think it was once a month.
They started, well, that's how the joke came about, because
is like nothing. That's like abuse. y'all might as well be in a long distance relationship.
That's abuse.
Like, yeah. I don't understand how y'all are in a marriage, in the same house. Yes, you have kids, but don't they have, like, a nanny or something? Because they argued about that last episode. Mm-hmm. They have a nanny. Like, get a babysitter or something. Have date night.
Yeah.
But I don't understand how Jennifer is even still keeping a husband. Like, she's getting this free plastic surgery. Oh. She's got, like, this huge house. She's living this housewife life. And once a month? Like...
Well... I think it's easy to keep him because divorce is something that's not...
That they don't do
that.
And they're already past
and
10 years.
And for something simple like sex, it would be really little to them to say, oh, I'm not having sex with you anymore, so let's get a divorce.
I also think it really depends on their love language as well.
Yeah.
So maybe sex isn't their love language and they have other things going on that we just don't know about.
Like plastic.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Plastic. Maybe he gets turned on by having her on an operating table and injecting her lips and liposuction her body. And he's
foreplay.
Like, oh, this is so hot.
Foreplay. Well, to each their own. To each their own. We don't judge.
People get off on the wildest things.
I could see a movie like that, but I don't know. But I think that that's very interesting because... like we said, with the whole private messaging and like it being so easy to cheat, and who's to say he's not? But I'm just saying, we don't know.
I don't think he's cheating.
He seems like I don't get much from Bill. Like
at
he
all.
Literally just got drunk for the first time. Like,
but
you
does
know.
That make him a cheater?
No,
not the drunk
means,
thing.
Yeah, it just means that we don't really know much about his character.
He's very capable of it.
Yeah.
And you know what I think is ironic too, that she thinks Jackie is boring, but her husband is boring as hell.
So boring.
The only time
so
he's entertaining is when he's intoxicated.
But I don't even know. They don't seem super affectionate to me. And we know that their marriage was arranged, which, you know, we don't want to insult their culture or anything like that because that's, you know, that's just what they do. But I don't see any affection. I do see Bill gets mad sometimes when they make comments about his wife, which is commendable.
Protective. I mean, typical male
thing. That's how anybody
should
be against their spouse.
Yeah. I mean, they should, but sometimes they aren't. We saw Joe call Teresa his B-I-T-C-H
but
wife.
But Joe wouldn't let someone else call Teresa that.
Yeah.
Like
and
a man will.
He disrespects her, but
yeah.
he said,
I disrespect my bitch.
Oh.
You don't disrespect my bitch.
Basically. But I don't know. That was interesting to see that, you know, she's got this glamorous life and I don't know, she just take care of the kids and live her life.
Mm-hmm.
And
that might be all he wants.
She see her husband when she see him, I guess.
Maybe in his mind he sees her as like a sexy French maid or a sexy nanny.
Once
and he's like, ooh, she's been home all day taking care of my kids. La, 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 la.
I'm gonna put her on a surgery table
and mm-hmm. give her something new.
And then in 3 weeks,
we're
going to
do nasties.
Yeah, they schedule it out. I don't know. But we also saw that that Frank has a girlfriend.
Thank you, Jesus.
She is 30 years old, but she does not sleep at the house because Dolores says she's got curfew.
You know what?
What's wrong with him dating a 30-year-old?
I don't get it.
I don't think anything. Do you think that Dolores still misses him? Because that definitely was a dig when she said she's got a curfew.
I thought that was weird
they
that she
both
was shady.
Said that they found each other attractive still.
Yeah.
Let me look up Frank. I don't think he's posted his girlfriend.
I just think there's nothing wrong with her being 30. Mm-hmm. Her making the curfew comment, that's dumb. You would think she was like 21 or in her 20s. So, and on top of that, Dolores, you got your man.
So what are you complaining?
She says that she has the best of both worlds. And this,
that was her talking.
I'm kind of confused though, because it makes it sound like they have an open relationship. Because she said like, we have the best of both worlds. And I have a guy that says go ahead, do what you want to do. And I also have a guy that, and at the same time, I have someone that I like to spend time with.
I do remember her saying that, but does she mean that she finds that in the same person, or she has two different...
I thought she meant in the same person, David.
Yeah.
That's why I'm like, is it an open relationship?
I don't know, but no one seems to like David. Like, they ask...
I really feel bad for David, because he really just has a demanding... But he has a demanding
career. He went to rifle school.
That's his choice.
The man chose rifle school.
I get you on that, but I'm saying he has a very demanding career, and I think the cast is, like, demonizing him for just the career itself, instead of pointing out those singulars, like, hey, the rifle school thing was way off. There's no reason he should have been there. But we understand why he's not normally around because of his career, but these one-offs where he's going to rifle school or he's doing something that's out of the ordinary is, like, inconsiderate towards
So my Dolores. Whole thing is, if he does have this demanding career where he can never schedule off because doctors, I don't know, can't get a fill-in or something. I don't know. Why doesn't he ever, like, make it up? Like, hey, you guys, I know I've been super busy lately.
See, that's what I would like to be mentioned by the cast.
Yeah, like...
But he doesn't do it. So
I know
he
I've been super busy
it.
Lately. I know I'm always on call. I know I choose rifle school over you. Mm-hmm. Oh. Let me... He does. Mm-hmm. He did. Let me plan out something for everybody. Just like Jackie said, hey, I've got a house in the Hamptons. You guys want to come? Just like... I don't know who it was suggested the Jersey Shore trip. They're always going on all these trips, mm-hmm. doing all these things. And never once have we seen David say, you know what? I don't show Dolores enough appreciation. I'm not around the group enough. Let me set something up for all of us to hang out. Yeah. Even if it's just...
Let me block off a hospital
or
room.
Or at least send...
He could do one night.
Or at least send a gift to Jackie and say, thank you for the invitation. I can't come. Yeah. Here's a fruit basket.
He doesn't
Something
do
that
anything.
Shows that you care.
Yeah. Like,
but when you have a woman that makes excuses for you, you don't
Talking
feel
about
like...
She's got
you
the
don't feel
world.
Like
him.
You have to make up for anything.
I feel like that. I feel like that was the hurt talking when she's like, I've got the best of both worlds, because no, like you said, if you can't make it, send a gift or something on your behalf. You got enough money.
Also, you're gonna set your own standards, and whether male or female, for your relationship, you set your own standards.
And he doesn't even have to plan a trip. I get it, he's a doctor, he's busy. Have one night at the brand new house you just built and say, hey, I've got a chef, guys, come over, have some drinks.
He doesn't feel the
need
to.
Question is, high-risk pregnancy doctors should have several nurse practitioners under them on a full 24-hour cycle.
I mean, I'm sure they do. I don't know
but
for
why are
sure.
These nurse practitioners are just as qualified as the doctors. If something goes down where the doctor's not there, they can handle almost every single thing that doctor can.
I don't know. I've just seen,
door.
Like, in movies, like... Say, for example, Knocked Up or something like that. And, like, they're about to go into labor and their doctor is at a bar mitzvah or something. They're, like, they still have a backup doctor. There's still someone else at the hospital. You think there's one doctor in the entire hospital that know how to deliver a baby?
I'm gonna look into it and see if he's in a private practice and who his... assistants are.
I think what just makes it worse is the fact that we see Dolores putting her all into this relationship that she's not getting anything back. And it's not even the fact that we're demonizing him because of his career, but it's just the fact that he hasn't shown any actions to show he's worth, like, saying, you know what, he's a good guy, he's innocent, all this other stuff. So until we see that, there's no reason to be... I feel like there's no reason for me to feel bad for him.
Same. I agree 100%. So, I mean, that was pretty much what we saw from the guys. There was a weird question about if you weren't with your current person, who else would you be with?
That is a weird question.
That was
in the
messy.
Cast, like, who would you be with in the cast?
Exactly. That was uncalled
for. First of all, no one wants to eat out the same dog dish. I'm sorry.
And I'm pretty sure, I don't know, that, like I said, it's just a weird question. But aside from that, we see that Danielle is finally going to be joining us. Of course, they've been dragging this out for quite some time, but she has arrived in a building, so she's getting her makeup done on this episode. So eventually...
First of all, let's talk about Danielle before we talk about Danielle on the reunion.
She
okay?
looked hurt.
Because she always tries to hold this power player move. First of all, she's not a main cast member. Mm-hmm. She's a friend role. Okay, so let's get that straight. Second of all, when we reached out to her... She wanted to also call the shots and omit any cast member from being here. And we can say that because it was not exclusive. The conversation and the negotiation was not exclusive. It was only going to be exclusive if we signed and had her here solo by herself letting out any cast members. And I've gotten responses from Margaret and Dolores and their people. Aww. But you cannot come onto a show that is not yours and demand things.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. You might have been season one holder, season two holder. But season 10, you are not a holder.
Yeah. Danielle is a little, I don't know. She's extreme. She always has been. And I don't know. At least she's getting this drawn out camera time because I don't know if she'll ever be back. I mean,
she's not coming back.
She's got no more friends on the show, on the sofas. Either. Yeah. So I don't know. Or maybe she'll do something crazy. Maybe she'll get married a few more times before they start filming for the next season.
She should do a dating show.
That would be
so
good.
She had her own show and she couldn't
be,
hold it.
She should
canceled.
Be on Millionaire Matchmaker.
Yeah.
Patty would have her
what
in line.
Money?
No. It's me like she's looking for the millionaire. She's getting matched up with millionaires.
That laugh from Russell.
I would watch that.
She has no money.
Because Patty would have her in line.
I said, what?
And they have been past Real Housewives of New Jersey people on the Millionaire Matchmaker.
Rosie.
Yeah, but...
I love me some Rosie.
But we will see Danielle, I guess, for the finale. We'll see if it goes down because, you know, this part two was better than part one, but it still wasn't up there with the drama. Yeah, it still wasn't what we needed. So we'll see if Danielle brings the drama, because I mean that's the only reason I feel like they would drag her out. But you know, the viewers are always talking.
Yes,
let's get into a special segment with the tweets with Bree.
Yes, tweets with Bree. So one tweeter we have named Jennifer says, I'm watching Real Housewives of New Jersey reunion for the second time tonight, and OMG, Jennifer gets dumber and dumber every time she opens her mouth.
You know what?
I believe that.
Me too.
Like I said, I like my girl Jennifer.
But she does say some
tonight,
dumb stuff.
Tonight she was interrupting a lot for no reason. Like in the beginning, I'm like, y'all just coming for her. But she did make a couple valid points about she was just defending herself when she went to the bathroom and Margaret spilled her business. And she was just defending herself tonight when she said Teresa's the one who posted the video, but y'all are only coming after me.
But I think when she's dumber and dumber is the fact that she... is okay with Teresa wanting a child with a different individual, but she's not okay with Melissa wanting a child with her husband. Like,
yeah, that didn't make sense.
Okay. Our next tweet says, am I the only one grossed out by Evan's response to Jackie telling the world she doesn't give him a BJ's? If there's enough peer pressure to force her into changing her mind and changing her actions, I'm just going to go with it and play a victim. Ew. I mean, I think he answered it pretty well.
Yeah,
what more are you going to say?
That?
I don't think there's any... Here's the thing. When it comes to any sexual relationship, there's things that one might not like and the other one might not like, but those opposite things might...
work out.
They might enjoy. However, so you have, like, any kind of relationship is give and take. It might not be your favorite thing, but I think you should consider your spouse's or co-partners.
I mean,
let me do this last tweet, guys, because we're running out of time. Melissa wants to have something that Teresa doesn't have so bad, she's going to convince her that her marriage was never good. We've seen Joe defend Teresa from Melissa and her bro while they ran her through the dirt trying to get clout for the show. And that's that on
Melissa,
that.
Melissa no wants words. Something that Teresa has?
Yeah, it's basically trying to say she's trying to beat down Teresa's marriage and make it seem like Joe wasn't really there emotionally.
I mean, was he? We just got finished talking about Joe in a bad way.
I mean, I have no words for that last tweet.
I don't know. But we got some news, Russell?
Yes, we got Jersey news.
AfterBuzz TV news.
So this week, Joe Giudice commented on Teresa's Instagram. As you guys can see, she's wearing a sequence, very cut out, very low V cut
dress.
She looks
like a mannequin.
This was actually from the reunion. This is a reunion dress. Mm-hmm. He quoted on her Instagram, nice boobs. But fans were quick to jump down his throat, calling him trash, saying, I hope she finds someone 10 times better than you. And the biggest dig, too bad you'll never know what they're like, you loser. Joe was quick to respond and said it was an inside joke. However, I don't agree with any sexual innuendos on past relationships. I think there's a certain line that you shouldn't cross. That's not your spouse. Let it go.
Also, with the whole nice boobs thing, you know, she had been talking about wanting boobs for a very long time, and I think he was the one against it. He's like, you're fine the way you are. That's something that she wanted and she got. Mm-hmm. So I don't think he was doing it to be flirty. Like, people are saying, too bad you'll never get to touch him. I don't think he wants to.
Yeah, I think that's just the public dragging something that they don't know anything about.
I saw a lot of people saying that he was being sarcastic with that, if anything. Like,
but that's the thing, it could go either way, and that should just be an untouched.
Well, if Teresa's not insulted
field.
I'm not insulted.
They're probably friends at this point, and that's something that, you know, Margaret or somebody else close to her would have said. They know she's wanted it for a while and she finally got it.
Does she get new boobs? I know she had them once, but does she get them again?
She might have got a touch up. I don't know.
Who, Teresa?
Yeah, because the first season she had nothing.
Probably got a lift.
Look, I was doing a lot better than Teresa season one, and then Teresa went ahead and went under the knife.
Okay.
And well, now, like, they, I don't know. There's Skims. She probably put on some Skims and just pulled them up a little bit, man. Look,
Skims. Shout out to Kim Kardashian once again. And on that note, let's get into predictions.
AfterBuzz TV predictions.
They'll be quick. Trust me, you guys.
I think Danielle's just gonna make a scene.
Yeah, she, like I said, she has to. This is her last shot on the show. It's part three of this drawn out reunion.
I think that Margaret's gonna have a Teresa moment. When Teresa back in season two got in Danielle's face, and I think Margaret's gonna pop up and get in Danielle's face, and we'll see how Danielle responds.
I would love to see it. And with that being said, that is the end of our show. You can find us online. I'm on Instagram at Angel Saunders.
I'm on Instagram at IMB_Cheyenne.
And I'm on Instagram at Russell Ray Silva.
Bye.
Our founder, Keven Undergaro, and me, Maria Menounos, would like to thank you for tuning in to AfterBuzz TV. Remember, we're not just the first, we're the biggest in the world, and we're the only destination for all your favorite TV shows. Whatever you crave, we've got it. So go to AfterBuzzTV.com and check out our lineup. Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.